In a meeting between the leaders from Mathiolo Town Council, Chitagwenda District, and the Wildlife Authorities at Katunguru Park office, local leaders decried the increased wild animal attacks that have led to the destruction of gardens, leaving residents with nothing to eat.
We have bought many electric torches, trying to get these elephants. What we are preparing to do tomorrow, we are going to make sure that we direct them to your home. They say for me, I don't manage. Even go to the friends for this to guard these animals.
Been facing a lot of complaints from the people because of animal-human conflicts. People have lost their crops, and a lot of danger has really been caused to our people because of these animals.
During the meeting, Captain John Tugume, a chief warden at Chambura Wildlife Reserve, revealed that the construction of electric fence will commence within 15. He added that most of the construction materials have already been put in place. According to him, this will resolve the burden of human-wildlife conflict, which has been on an increase in areas of Chitagwenda.
And it is today that these leaders have witnessed that TUWA is a serious organization in reducing these conflicts. So far, we have procured all necessary equipment to see that electric fence starts in Mashioro. And we have promised these leaders, and themselves they have witnessed, that we are starting this exercise within 3 weeks from today.
But we are also aware that people also need water from the river, because the river is where they get their water from, for their animals and their own use. So for such purposes, we shall be leaving, we shall create provisions for them to get water as we move on the ground.
Human-wildlife conflicts have been a big challenge to the communities of Mathiolo. He says over 14 kilometers of the electric fence will be constructed.
We have two serious issues in Mathioro as a town council. One is of human-wildlife conflict, especially human-elephant conflict. That has been a challenge for years I can't calculate now. That is the major problem we want to address.
Discussion with our officials on how the electric fence in my area bordering with Queen Elizabeth will be constructed. Now I am sure that the fence will soon start, and it will relieve the problem from my farmers.
Residents are convinced that if this program begins, human wildlife conflict problems will be solved and they will finally be able to benefit from their agriculture produce. At our place, we do not have cassava, maize, banana plantation. All our gardens were destroyed by elephants. Our children can no longer go to school. We really have nothing left. But if we get the electric fence, it will be a huge milestone.
The work will start. So, this problem of the communities saying we are being deceived, the work cannot start. Even the project has been diverted to other areas, now is going to be history.
According to Uganda Wildlife Authorities, they have plans of constructing 61 kilometers of electric fence in various national parks, but the priority is given to Chitagwenda since it has more human-wildlife conflicts. Report compiled by Anthony Atwine for the news.